Hey gamers, today I'm going to share the experiences that I had upgrading to Windows 11 from Windows 10. If you don't want to see what the experience was like for me, then go ahead and skip to the timestamp on the screen where I will be comparing the gaming performance that I got from Windows 10 and Windows 11. To summarize what it's like, I thought Windows 11 was a pretty good upgrade, but the experience to getting Windows 11 installed was quite rough. My first step to installing Windows 11 was checking whether my PC was compatible using the health check app provided by the Microsoft website. I ran through the check and it said I had to enable a setting called TPM 2.0 in the BIOS. This process isn't hard or anything, but for some of you who aren't familiar with the BIOS, it can be a bit intimidating. To reach the BIOS, I held shift and pressed restart. This brought me to an interface where I found an option called UEFI firmware settings. I clicked on it and it brought me straight to the BIOS page. Your BIOS will look different depending on the brand of your motherboard, but ultimately it should all fall within the security category. If you struggle with the settings or are too afraid to navigate through the BIOS by yourself, I recommend watching tutorials on YouTube about your motherboard brand and how to enable the TPM settings in their respective menu. If you do happen to have an MSI motherboard, just follow what I did on the screen and you should be good to go. After the TPM setting was enabled, my health check app told me that I was good to install Windows 11. This meant that I could move on to step 2, which was downloading the Windows 11 installation assistant. At that point, I thought I was pretty much done until another error appeared on my screen. This time, the assistant told me that I was missing a driver called CFOS Speed. I had no idea what this was, and turns out I just needed to install this program from the CFOS Speed official website. Following the driver installation, I ran the installation assistant again, and thankfully it remembered the previously downloaded files and resumed the installation from where I left off. 20 minutes passes by, and my PC was ready to install Windows 11. I pressed the Restart Now button, and my PC proceeded to restart after 20 seconds. Around 5 minutes later, the start screen popped up.
Oh my god.
And I don't know if you can tell, but I was pretty excited. I entered my password and it continued installing Windows 11. The screen started taunting me with almost there and boom, I was in Windows 11. Right away, I booted up Task Manager just to check if everything was still the same. And the first bug that I came across was that my CPU was apparently running at 6.9 GHz. Nice. Anyhow, this entire process took around an hour and a half, which isn't too long, but definitely longer than what I anticipated. So jumping straight back to the topic of should you upgrade to Windows 11 for gaming, you can see that there is virtually no difference in FPS for Fortnite. Everything was within the margin of error and nothing can be concluded about which Windows was better. The same goes for Apex Legends. Both datasets suggested that the performance on Windows 11 and Windows 10 are very similar, with an average FPS of around 230 and a low of 180. Switching to League of Legends, and the same story can be said here. Both Windows 10 and 11 had an average of around 313 FPS and a low of 268 FPS. Minecraft was the first game where we see a little difference, but keep in mind that this can very well be caused by where I was looking and where I was running. I would still say the performance on Minecraft is the same on Windows 10 and Windows 11. Now, last but not least, I tested Valorant. Interesting enough, Valorant was the first game where I found some issues loading in. I got an error saying this build of Vanguard requires TPM version 2.0 and Secure Boot to be enabled in order to play. I did a quick YouTube search, then changed a few settings related to the secure boot in the BIOS, and fortunately, these changes were able to make my Valorant run successfully. I did a quick test, and very surprisingly, my Windows 11 test had a much better benchmark than the Windows 10 test, almost a 100 FPS difference in average FPS. Now, I'm not sure whether it is caused by the secure boot setting in the BIOS, but I did notice that on Windows 11, the GPU usage seems to always be a little higher than on Windows 10, which could mean that Windows 11 is better utilizing the graphics card. For more in-depth gaming tests, I recommend checking out Gerald's tech channel, as he will be doing a more comprehensive gaming performance comparison between Windows 10 and 11 the next week. So what can we conclude from this? Well, while it is unfortunate that Windows 11 won't bring performance gains compared to Windows 10, it is nice knowing that you can upgrade to Windows 11 without losing much performance. Well, at least on my end. There have been rumors about another BIOS setting called VBS and will be enabled on upcoming Windows 11 pre-built PCs, which can drop your gaming performance by as much as 30%. Luckily, it does seem like this setting can be disabled by the user, so that shouldn't be a problem for both pre-built and custom PC users. Another issue that seems to be floating around is the L3 cache and the CPU getting tanked by Windows 11. Specifically, Ryzen computers seem to suffer the most from this problem. This can decrease gaming performance in CPU-bounded titles such as CSGO, Valorant, and League of Legends by as much as 15%. Though, this issue has also been somewhat resolved for most games, and as seen in my tests, they were not apparent. The only new feature that is available to gamers right now in Windows 11 is Auto HDR. This feature allows Windows to automatically apply HDR content to gaming, web surfing, and watching videos. For me, it's not a significant addition, as I don't really consume HDR content. If you do happen to watch HDR content, this might be a pleasant feature to have. If you are interested in the Auto HDR feature, I recommend watching this video from Linus Tech Tips. Lastly, Direct Storage is another technology that is making its way to Windows 11. It can dramatically reduce game load times and allow quick resumes for games. Though, this will be available for Windows 10 users in the future, so this shouldn't be part of the reason of why you're upgrading to Windows 11. If you are purely looking for gaming benefits on Windows 11, then there is almost no reason to switch right now, as most games will instead be more unstable. Besides gaming, I think there are a lot of nice changes in Windows 11 that will make you want to switch. For starters, we have a way better looking font style throughout the whole system of Windows 11, a way cleaner looking UI, smoother animations, sleeker icons, calming sound effects. New notification tray, and a new taskbar. These changes make it feel more like macOS in the visual perspective, and I think it's a good enough of a reason to upgrade. However, there are some features missing, like being able to change the size of the taskbar icons and the ability to disable the recommended apps in the start menu. The most annoying part about Windows 11 is that you have to press multiple buttons to perform one action. For example, the need to press Show More Options when you want to access all the features in File Explorer. On top of that, you can't customize the location of the Windows icon, search icon, and the notification icons other than moving the entire taskbar to the left. My least favorite part about the upgrade experience was that Windows 11 doesn't even support drag and drop. Something so simple and important, yet it's missing from such a big change. Aside from the bad user experience, there is one feature that I really like, and that's the snapping feature you get when you hover your cursor over the square icons on the top right side of the border. It splits up your screen into sections and allows you to multitask much easier on a single monitor setup. Windows 11 also seems to have better integration for touchscreen, so if you own a touchscreen capable laptop or a tablet that runs Windows 11, I think that could be a good reason to upgrade. To conclude, if you're not afraid of bugs and stability issues and want to experience the latest Windows redesign, then go ahead and upgrade to Windows 11. But if you're a heavy user who needs the best stability in apps or a gamer that wants to seek the best FPS and stability, then I recommend holding off your upgrade for now and come back to it when things are settled. After all, you don't want to have your computer crash in the middle of a clutch situation. For me, I really enjoy the visual artifacts that Windows 11 brings me, and I don't regret upgrading. So far, my gaming experience has stayed the same and I've yet to crash. Sure, there are lots of bugs and problems that I will need to face besides gaming, but as a tech enthusiast, this has been an amusing experience, and I hope some of you are convinced to try it out. it really isn't that bad if you expect for the worst to happen. I mean, look, it clearly is an unfinished product. It literally forgot how to drag and drop or how to change colors. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, I've linked some videos in the description to some of the problems I face upgrading to Windows 11. You can check those out if you happen to face the same issues. Anyhow, that wraps up my half serious and half joking Windows 11 experience. If you want, subscribe to the channel for more tech related things, like the video if you enjoyed, dislike it if you disliked it, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.